Hello everyone, welcome back to Shohu's Tech Tips, episode 2 on WhatsApp voice messaging. Today we will be using our iPhone instead, so we can show you how different it is from Android. 大家好，欢迎回到我们的修护科技指南第二集。今天我会示范的是那个 WhatsApp 的语音发简讯，但是这一次呢，我们会用的是那个 iPhone。那你们可以看看一下 iPhone 和那个安卓的分别在哪里。So first up, we're gonna tap into our WhatsApp. 第一步，我们先点进我们的 WhatsApp。当然。Of course, you look for someone that you want to talk to. So, 我们会找一个我们想聊天的朋友。So, let me tap into the one. 点进去。And now, just like Android phone, we also have a space or field for you to start chatting. 我们跟安卓同学差不多一样，也是有一个格子在这里，让你可以打字。So by default, we'll always use this very simple tool where we'll just have a few words. So let me just show hi. So 我先打一个 hi and send. As you can see, the main difference is we actually can change our languages using the little globe here. 所以我们其实可以用这个地球来更换我们的那个语言。And of course, the number of languages depends on your settings.我们拥有的那个这里可以找到的语言呢，都是根据你自己曾经设置过的语言种类而定。So if you press and hold on to this globe, 如果点击按着这个按钮的话， you can actually see a whole menu of all the language that you have. 所以你可以看到一个菜单，里面会显示所有我们现在可以使用的那个语言。So for example, let's want to type Chinese. 打个比方，我要打一些华语字。I can choose简体拼音 This is the 汉语拼音 style I'll just tap 点击一下 And now I can type like 你好 Just for example And send Of course this is basic messaging And of course today's topic is actually more about our voice 当然这个只是一个简单的那个打字示范但是今天我们真正要学的是我们的语音简讯 So first upVoice recording. 第一项就是我们的录音功能。Just like the Android phone, you'll find that there's a little microphone on the top right here for iPhones. 像我们的安卓手机一样，其实我们的右手旁也可以看到一个麦克风的形状。唯一的分别是它没有一个绿色的圆圈围绕着。So, like the iPhone, like Android,If I just tap and hold onto this button, 如果我现在点击按着这个麦克风按钮的话，它就开始在录音了。You can see it starts to record. And like before, you can see here, there's actually a timer that is running. And that means that we are actually recording for 14, 15 seconds. So 我们现在你看已经录了差不多已经到了21秒了。At this point, after you've finished talking or finished saying the message, if you let go, it will automatically send this message out to your friend. 如果现在直接放手的话，他就会把录好的这个时间呢，直接发给我们的朋友。So I'm just gonna let go. 放开，你看 ，automatically it sends out the message. Okay, so that's for one.So, 简单吧，这是第一步。So, let me just tap and hold onto the button again. 我再点击长按那个按钮。As you can see, the same thing happens. And you can see the timer running. 时间还在跑。But what if, let's say, we say something wrong or we sang a wrong note when we sing a song to our friend? 那如果你在唱一首歌给朋友的话呢，还是你说错话还是走音的时候你怎么办呢 Just like the Android 就像安卓的一样 You just need to slide your hand or your thumb or your finger towards the left 只要向左滑 As you can see The message gets deleted 那个语音就被删除掉了 Let me just show you one more time. 再做多一次。Tap and hold. 点击上按。如果要删除的话，向左滑。If you want to delete this voice recording, slide towards the left. 哒哒，就这样，被删除了。So thirdly, we're going to show you the function of the last function the voice recording can do. 所以我们现在示范最后一个那个录音可以做到的一个功能。So same thing, we're going to just tap in the hole. 同样的，我们点击长按。You can see it starts to count down. It starts to count. 你看还是开始在录音了。On the top, actually, you'll notice there's a little lock. 你会发现其实我手指上方有一个小锁头。You have to slide upwards. 如果向上滑的话 it will actually lock the recording. And I do not need to use my hand, so it's hands-free. 所以你会发现当我已经滑上去的时候它已经锁住了那个录音的那个功能。所以我根本不需要用到我的手指。As you can see, the number is still running and it's still recording my voice. And let's say if I want to send, I can just tap the send button. 如果我要发送的话呢直接点那个发送 and you'll send. I'm just going to repeat one more time. 再做多一次。Tap and hold, 点击长按。Look for the lock on the top, 找那个上面的锁头。Slide up, 向上滑。And it will lock, 它就锁住了。Remember when you're talking on your iPhone or any other phones and you're doing voice recording, make sure that your mouth sticks to close to the bottom of the phone. 记得如果你在做任何一个录音的话呢，确保你的嘴巴靠近你的手机的下方，因为麦克风就在下面。So here, for example, if I want to send out this recording, I can just tap the arrow and it will be done. 当然我可以直接点这个箭头，它就已经算是可以发出去了。But let's say if you kind of sing off key, 如果你唱歌唱走音的话 and you really don't want to send this or you said something wrong, 如果你讲错话 how do you cancel? Actually, if you notice there's a middle word that says cancel, 应该会注意到其实中间有一个字叫删除的。Yeah, I'm going to tap this, 如果点它的话 it will actually delete that voice recording. 它就会把刚刚我们录的那个录音给删除掉了。So, that's it for voice recording. 所以这就是那个录音的三大需要知道的那个功能的存在。Next up, we're going to learn about voice typing. 下一个我们学的是语音打字。And don't blame me for being a little bit biased, but actually iPhone's voice typing function is probably one of the better ones that I've seen. 别怪我偏心，但是因为我使用的手机之后，发现苹果手机的那个语音打字其实功能非常好。So I'm going to show you how why voice typing for iPhone is better. 所以我会示范给你看那个语音打字是怎么做的。Firstly, let me just switch back to English. 我先把语言换回英文。So, if you have not noticed, actually all our iPhones have a secondary microphone, which is actually right here beside the spacebar. 如果你有注意到的话，其实我们键盘上面还有多一个麦克风，就在这个空格的左方，在下方这里。If you were to tap onto that microphone, it will allow you to actually do voice typing. 如果你点击下面的那个麦克风的话，那一个就是我们的语音打字功能。So I'll just do a quick demo. 我先做一个小示范。Hello everyone, welcome to Xiuhu TV. 大家好，欢迎来到 Xiuhu TV.As you can see, it can only listen to one language at a time. And you'll see that this is actually how loud my voice is. 所以你看到的是他现在只能一次过听一个语言，所以你看我现在怎么说华语的话只会看到英文字出现，而且你会看到我的那个语音的大小在这里。 If you have finished doing the recording, you can actually just tap this little、keyboard on the right here. 如果你已经讲完你的那个录音的话呢，你可以直接点这个键盘，它就会停止再继续、打字。So I'm just going to tap. So I'll just 点一下。So it stops the recording. So of course now I'm just going to delete all the words that I said earlier. 我现在把所以之前说的话先删除掉。And I'm going to just show you one more time. 我再做重复多一次。直接点击那个麦克风。Just tap onto the microphone. Just remember, you do not need to tap and hold. 记得不需要长按哦，只要点一下就行。Just tap once. And now, it is listening to what I'm saying. There's one amazing thing about the iPhone is it can actually input punctuation marks as you require. So for example, exclamation mark.Full stop, comma. 所以 iPhone 有一个特点是它可以让你说出标点符号呢，也可以打出那个符号出来。Of course you can see that now because it's in English, it will just be reading whatever I say in Chinese and interpret it in English. 当然你会看到现在我们还是在那个英文的那个选项，所以它其实看起来不是很准。因为他只听得懂英文。So, how can you actually change your language? 怎么可以换语言呢？ Just remember, before you start talking, change to the language that you prefer to speak in. 所以记得先把键盘换去你要打字的语言，再开始那个你要说的语音。So, for example, 打个比方， let's change to Chinese. 先把它换去华语了。And now let me start the recording, the voice typing. 我再重新开始那个语音打字。大家好，欢迎来到我们相助 TV。希望你们喜欢今天的课程。感叹号，问号。逗号，句号。As you can see in this example, I'm able to actually voice out punctuation marks, and it actually captures my Chinese pretty accurately. 你会发现的是，其实它蛮快的，直接可以阅读到我说的话，而且可以打出蛮精准的那个字体，而且刚才我说的标点符号都。一一的打出来了，对不对？ So you can see the accuracy of iPhone is actually pretty high, and that's why I really love about using iPhone's voice typing as opposed to other brands. 所以你会发现其实我非常喜欢用的是苹果的那个语音打字，因为它的准确性非常高，而且它那个聆听的那个速度也非常快。所以其实拿来打字用反而方便很多。 So that's it for today's topic. So we have demonstrated voice recording and we also have demonstrated voice typing. 所以今天我们已经示范了两个不同的语音发展性的方法，当然一个是我们的录音，另一个是我们的语音打字。 Thank you very much for listening inand watching our videos. 谢谢你们观看我们的影片。 So please remember to like and also follow us on Facebook, or you can also find us on YouTube. 你也可以记得给我们按赞，还有在我们的那个脸书的那个页面发留言，要不然你们也可以上 YouTube 来看我们的影片。 So we'll see you in the next episode. And please take care, stay safe, and stay home. 所以大家请照顾，谢谢你们观看，记得好好休息，还有最好待在家。再见，拜。